Think organic fertilizers are safe, chemical fertilizers are fast. What if I told you both could be helping or hurting your orchids depending on how you use them? Today, we're going to break down the truth behind the fertilizers that you are using and what your orchids wish that you knew. We'll go into the pros and cons of both the organic fertilizers and the chemical fertilizers and try and give you a better idea on which is going to be more suitable for your orchids or how to go about using them to ensure that you get the results that you are looking for. So let's dive straight into it. Comparing the two head to head might be an easier way to understand the difference between the two of them. The chemical formulations come in every sort of formulation imaginable for all sorts of different applications, from blooming to vegetative growth to seedling stages, and you can find whatever you need in whatever ratios you need in exact quantities. And that makes it easy to be able to decide when and how to apply the different chemical fertilizers. With the organic fertilizers, we also get such a big broad range of different products available, from just pure nutrient feeds to supplements that have got growth hormones in them, to biostimulants with amino acids in them. So it can start getting a bit murky as what to use when, but that doesn't become too problematic when it comes to organic fertilizers, but we'll get to that in a bit. With these precise formulations that you're getting in your chemical fertilizers, you know you're going to get predictable results. The results are going to be the same every time because what you are adding to your orchid is going to be precise and measured to the exact amounts that you are requiring for that specific outcome. With the organic plant foods, you can hit into a little snag there too. Because they're organic products, you're never too sure what the exact ingredients were that went into the making of the product to ensure that your formulations are exactly the same each time. And especially with something like compost tea or worm tea, you're never sure what went into producing it, so you're never sure exactly whether you're going to be getting the same nutrient values out of it every time. Although I must admit, with some of these newer formulations, they do come with their specified quantities of the different ingredients, which does make it a little bit more helpful. And with the chemical products, all of the nutrients provided are in their ionic forms, which means they're going to be immediately available to the plant, which is not necessarily true with your organic products because these are generally not the ionic forms. These are more complex compounds than just your basic nutrient ions. And in certain of the forms that some of these nutrients may come in, they may need a longer period of time for them to become available to the plant. But that's not necessarily always true, because in the wild, the orchids do draw in these nutrients from these more complex compounds that are found in these organic products. So it's not necessarily always true that the chemical fertilizers are going to be faster than the organic fertilizers. And also, in this regard, we also get some added benefits using your organic compounds, because for one, they're going to help the mycorrhizal fungi in and around your orchids in the media that the orchid is in. This is going to help make any of those other nutrients that are available in that media available more easily and quickly to the plant as well. It will also help for faster reduction of some more complex chemicals into forms that the plant itself then can use. It will help with disease resistance and the overall health of the plant. So often feeding with organic fertilizers is more like giving it a proper meal plan as opposed to just feeding it up with vitamin supplements. But that's another story altogether. Let's just keep with what we're doing. Also, with the organic fertilizers, you're going to get things like your amino acids. You'll probably also get, with products like kelp, you're getting plant hormones, your auxins, your gibberellins, your cytokinins, and things like that. That's going to help your plant's growth in different ways. There are also things like humic and fulvic acids that also help with the absorption of nutrients into your plant. Also, with all these compounds, they help with the buffering of the pH in your media. This helps maintain the correct pH for the absorption of nutrients, which may not necessarily happen with your chemical fertilizers. But what can happen with your chemical fertilizers is if you are feeding and you are not flushing, what can then happen to those ions through just basic contact with the air or other chemical processes that happen in the media is that you'll land up with those ions then being changed into a form that is not usable by the plant, and you land up with a salt buildup in your media. This is especially in inorganic medias where the air movement is high and it can dry out the media quickly, and you land up with those salt deposits in and around your media. This is going to be damaging to your plants itself, and you're going to have to make sure you flush a lot to get all of those excess salts out. Whereas you're not going to have the same problem with organic fertilizers. They're not going to leave salt deposits in your media because, for one, the majority of them, they have a very low salt content. Those compounds that the nutrients are in are not going to leave salt residues on the media in the same way as your chemical compounds. You're not going to land up with excess salts in your media to burn the roots. Also, talking about burning the roots, with your chemical fertilizers, you can do that quite easily to your orchids by not sticking to your mixing instructions. In fact, you may need to half or quarter your feeding doses for your orchids than what the product may suggest, because the quantity of those ions in that feed may be too high for what is suitable for the orchid. Whereas with the organic compounds in your organic fertilizers, you generally won't have the same problem. For one, the quantity of those micronutrients and macronutrients for that matter are generally a lot lower. So you're going to get lower concentrations of them, which means you're not going to build them up in toxic levels as easily as you will with your chemical fertilizers. Invariably, they're in formats that are biodegradable and will form compounds that are non-toxic. So you're not going to have the same problem with your orchids there either. And as I was ranting on about the mycorrhizal support that your organic compounds give you, or that your organic fertilizers give you, you don't get any of that with your chemical compounds. In fact, you may get the opposite, because you are supplying so much salt into your media that perhaps those salts can then overpower those mycorrhizal fungi and other microorganisms and cause their death. So be sure with your chemical fertilizers to stick to your feeding regime. Don't think you're going to add extra and do good for your orchid. But indeed, the same goes for your organic fertilizers, because not only with all those good things like your amino acids, your organic compounds, all those nutrients, you also get natural sugars. And an overdose of that natural sugar, which is going to be help feeding those mycorrhizal fungi, can also then start bringing things like insects, even those fungal gnats, things like that, and also pathogenic fungi too. All of these other bad elements can also come when you're overfeeding with organic fertilizers. So you still have to balance your use of fertilizers no matter which one you choose. And with your chemical fertilizers, you can also land up with some environmental impact, which generally is not going to be applicable to most home growers, because they're not going to be using enough of it for it to flood off into the groundwater or anything. So that's generally not something. It's only for the large growers who are feeding on mass scales that generally there can be some ecological impact of using chemical fertilizers. But of course, your organic ones are exactly that: organic, non-toxic, and environmentally friendly. Also, with the chemical fertilizers, they can often be really cost effective. You may be paying a lot for a small amount, but that small amount is generally going to go a long way. You're looking at the cost per feeding, and invariably your chemical fertilizers can last or have a very, very long shelf life as opposed to some of your organic plant foods. So if you're only having a few orchids and you're buying large bottles, you'll end up having to perhaps use the rest of the bottle on your house plants or your garden plants, or the rest will just go to waste after the expiry date. But then also, options are now available for smaller amounts that are more suitable for the home grower. And included in that is a lot of those DIY home fertilizers, which you can produce yourself too. We do have a few videos to a couple of the different ones we have suggested, and we'll drop those in the description box down below. When it comes to the nutrient profiles of your fertilizers, as I said, your chemical fertilizers come in a wide variety of different formulations for your different needs. So you can always find ones that include all the nutrients that you need for your orchids. So you can use perhaps just a single application of the same fertilizer throughout the year, which makes it really easy and simple. You can then change it up for the blooming or vegetative phases if you want, but it's still really easy to do. With your organic fertilizers, you may find that not all of them have all the macro and micronutrients that you are needing for healthy growth of your plant. So you may then find that you need to add in additives, whether it's using a chemical micronutrient additive into your organic foods to ensure that they've got the full spectrum of micronutrients for your orchids, or whether it's using a home DIY micronutrient solution. And if you're interested in hearing what we often use, then drop a comment in the box below and we'll be sure to do a video on how to make that homemade DIY micronutrient solution to add to your organic fertilizers. It's going to be really cheap and it's effective. So what's going to be best for your orchids? Using products that are easy to use, that have a fast, quick absorption rate, that provide all the exact nutrients you need in the quantities that you specifically want, that's going to be clean and hassle-free and easy to manage. With the only warnings being that you have to be extremely careful with your application rates and ensuring that you are flushing regularly, or using other products that have a much broader spectrum of available compounds that are good for your orchid, like your amino acids, your fulvic and humic acids, your organic proteins, those natural sugars, and that will then help your plant in the long term inside the pot with that mycorrhizal fungi and allowing for micronutrients to be chelated in the media itself, which will then make them available to the plant along with all those other multiple functions that all those different compounds do. You may have to be a little bit more careful on what you're using, when you're using, and how you're using it to ensure that you're getting the full spectrum of macro and micronutrients that your plant will then need. So whether it's ensuring that you're adding supplements in or biostimulators, or whether it's just adding an extra small amount of the chemical micronutrients supplement. All of this has to be looked at in the broader spectrum of how you care for your orchids. Because for me, I use the organic products and I rotate my organic products to ensure that, for one, not only is my plant getting all the nutrients from each of the different types of organic feeds that they are, but they're also getting all those extra compounds and those plant hormones to ensure that they grow well. But I don't only use them, I do use the chemical feeds too. But I use these chemical fertilizers a lot less frequently and only during those active growth phases. I use them as a little bit of a cheat as well, because the ones that I use have both cytokinins and auxins in them to help specific stages of my orchid growth. And I generally use them to help produce or force out more of those lateral buds. Even though I still do use my seaweed extract, I just use that as an extra little kick in the nuts, if you want to put it that way, to really get things started. So in my opinion, for me, the best way that I can suggest that you go about feeding your orchids is giving them a healthy diet and then giving them the boost when they need it. That fast, quick dose of Red Bull to really get them going, because this is going to keep your plants healthier in the long term, allowing for not only healthy plants, strong roots, but also that vibrant mycorrhizal ecosystem that is going to help protect your plant from disease and attacks. But I do realize not everyone is able to grow like we do, and certain of these organic products do have a strong scent to them, which can be off-putting, especially if you are growing indoors. And then it's completely understandable why you stay away from organic products and stick with the chemicals. There are some organic products now that really don't have a scent, And perhaps if you wanted to, you could look into some of those, and perhaps it can help you in your growing. Also, certain people grow completely aseptically. They try and keep all fungus and bacteria away from their plants whatsoever. So they're using chemical pesticides and fungicides all the time. And in that case, perhaps they generally prefer to stick with the chemical fertilizers, as well as it allows them to control their environment and their feeding completely. And if you need any further information on fertilizers and their uses for orchids, please go have a look at that Buy Me a Coffee link down below. Ed posts up a lot of orchid related content there all the time that is free for everyone. There is some members only content, so don't be shy. Sign up, become a member, and grow like a pro. Thank you for watching. And if you found any of this information helpful, please hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and that notification bell, bing bong, to be notified of all our upcoming content so you don't miss out on a thing. Help us grow as we help your orchids grow.